No, it's Friday, Friday, Friday. Hi guys, it's Friday once again and welcome back to We Are Androgyny with Glasses. Boop. So, what was that? Like, seriously. Yeah. Glasses today. Usually, I don't wear glasses. Wearing them again, I kind of feel like I read books for a living kind of thing. No. This week on We Are Androgyny, we are taking it back to that was last week. We do not say that no more. Okay, so this week we are doing the throwback tag, which basically means you're gonna see me as a fat child.
What?
So, yeah, you're gonna see me as a fat child. I don't want it. No, it's fine. See me as a fat child. I don't care. Okay, so also I'll show you the canvas. I started the canvas that I said I did was going to start in last week's video for my niece and nephew. So you can see that. It's like half done. Yay. It's quite big. That's what she said. So question one is, when were you born? I was born on the 1st of July 1994 at about 8:30 in the morning. God knows why I was up that early. Okay, so question two is, do you have any pictures of yourself as a young child? I do, because my parents were camera happy. I'm just going to show you these in a shitty order, so they're not going to be like from me getting smaller to bigger and me getting smaller to bigger. You don't shrink and then get big. I don't get that. So this is... Shit, the glare is appalling. That's me. What a horrible child. This is me as a fat child. We lived in Greece, so we were black people, pretty much.
Yay!
This is when we lived in England and we were white. You know what, we couldn't make our skin colour up, you know. We were just that, wanna be black, wanna be white, wanna be in the middle. What? So this is me and my older sister. She's reading me a book. That's how she rolls. This is me and my younger sister, like legit tit heads. Like, look at those tits on our heads. We had tits on our heads. Me posing for Vogue. Obviously, look at that. Tits out and everything. Dirty little slut. Me again, being a fat, excited child. Proper love in life. Like, I was a crazy child. I was always smiling, never not smiling. Fat child again. Me eating cake. Yet again, I was a fat child. Me being a fat child. My older sister, whoop, fat child again. Damn it, me and a fat child now. This is when we were in Greece. Whoa, it's huge. Can you see this car thing? I don't even know what it is. This is the best family picture we have of us three, the siblings. We're cute as hell. Also, everybody, well, most people know that I have a fascination with owls from a young age. So that's me with two owls, because I'm a crazy person. Crazy. This is me with owls. I made you shit yourself. This is me being a sweaty beast. Sweaty, sweaty. Me again. For some reason, I look fake tanned. Obviously, I started from a young age. And then this is, well, I was always a kid that hung around with the girls. Look at that. There's me, and then every fucker else is girls. Here's another picture with all me and all the girls. And me being retarded and dancing on a bar because, well, I was let into clubs and bars at the age of fucking stupidness. I was like -5 and they were like, sure, you can come in. And then this is a bigger picture of me from school because, well, what the frick did you even want because of that? Can you really believe that that's me? Like, this thing to this thing. I don't know. Okay, we're gonna move on to question three because that probably took up like 6 minutes, so yeah. Okay, so question three is, what TV show did you grow up on? I grew up on... I don't even know. What did I grow up on? I didn't watch much TV as a child, surprisingly. SpongeBob, like, oh my god, SpongeBob. I still watch it to this day. There's something wrong with me. And then when it kind of got more to the, you know, you start going from the kids' channels to stuff like Charmed and all that. I grew up on Charmed anyway, which was a good show. I watched every single episode until all of them had kids and then died and it was dramatic. So yeah. Question four is, what did you want to be when you grow up? And do you still want to be that to this day? Surprisingly, no. Before I wanted to be a musician, I wanted to be a marine biologist, which is swimming with the fishes. So yeah, you do scuba diving and you do deep sea diving. You know that you get scientist labs that are under the sea, like way too far down, that it's ridiculous. I wanted to go there and be all scientific and amazing, and I was gonna do it, and then realized I didn't like the idea of dying or being eaten alive by giant sea creatures, so that was out the window. And then after that I wanted to be a musician, and ever since that, that's all I've ever done. It's been a musician. Okay, so question five is, show a video clip of you when you're a child. I'll insert it here.
Oh, right, can you see me?
Yeah.
Can you see me now?
Yeah.
Can you see me now?
I should have stayed where you were because your head wasn't fixed to your body there. Oh. It's small.
Ricky's behind the cooker.
Too far.
Right. Can you see me now?
No.
No.
No. Right, watch. Can you see my head?
Yeah! You look like an alien!
Slowly, 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 slowly.
Right, and then move your head a bit.
Put your head across your head.
Did you get that? I'm just keep going.
Okay, so question six, what were your favourite toys to play with? Okay, well, I guess my favourite toys to play with were consoles. I was a console kid. I absolutely loved playing like PS1, Sega. Jesus Christ, Sega was a beast for me. Like, I loved it. So yeah, I was a console kid. I didn't really play with Barbies. Whatever. Question seven? I think we're on seven. What is the most embarrassing thing you can remember doing? It's weird. I don't tend to get embarrassed much. I mean, I've walked into a lamppost in public and was just, I enjoyed it, surprisingly. I kind of just found it funny. I've fallen out of a bus, face first. That's funny. I've fallen over in public too many times, surprisingly. Surprisingly. But I don't really get embarrassed. I kind of just laugh and enjoy it. I mean, it's funny. I walked into a lamppost and fell off a bus. So, you know. We're moving on to question eight. Okay, so question eight is, read something you've written in kindergarten. Surprisingly. Wow. Say. Okay, well, these are letters that I did when I was a kid. You're gonna be able to read this? It was just little letters to my mother, like Happy Mother's Day cards and all that jazz. Surprisingly, there's not many spelling mistakes or retarded. The handwriting is just appalling. I don't know if you're gonna see that. Alright, question nine. What is one song? Is it one song? I don't know. Three songs that you love to listen to as a child. I can only remember one. We're gonna play it now. Let's hope I don't get arrested for breaking copyright laws. Who cares? So yeah, I listened to this as a child. I didn't have a clue what it was about. Hey mama, it's that shit that make you move, mama. Get on the floor and move your booty, mama. But yeah, this is the song that I listen to. We never die, no, we never deceive. We multiply like we math Matisse. And we drop bombs like we in the Middle East. The bass, fun drummers. Drop down, move me on.
Gain the stars, steady rock, warriors, boulevards, and looking hard without bodyguards. I do what I am.
What I am, and still I stand. We're done with that. So come on, mama. This is the shit that make you move, mama. Get on the floor and move your booty, mama. Yeah, the last master's blasting up your jamma. So shake your bum, mama. Come on now, mama. This is the shit that make you move, mama. Get on the floor and move your booty, mama. Yeah, the last master's blasting up your jamma. Whoa, whoa. We the big town stuffers, the big town pumpers, the big town. Alright, we're done. We're done. Trump, Trump, oh. The girlies in the club got the plump lump lumpers and wanna make it. Okay, so after that shenanigans, question 10. Question 10 is, what is one thing that's funny you dressed up as for Halloween? I didn't say that right, but you know what I mean. I dressed up as a giant pumpkin. Giant pumpkin, like literally. It was like made out of coat hangers, and it was literally, well, I can't even fit on the screen how freaking big it was. I could barely fit through a freaking door frame. But I won. I won the little competition thing of best Halloween thingy. Yay to me. Sung up as a giant pumpkin. Great. Enjoyed it. Obviously. You know, revisiting fat childhood and all that jazz. Okay, question 11 is, tell a story of something that you tell a story that you remember. Obviously, you cannot remember the fucking question. Okay, so question whatever the fuck we're on. Tell a funny story that you remember happening as a child. Something that was funny. I mean, we were having a barbecue and someone was making a barbecue and we snuck upstairs with a giant bucket of water and poured it out the top window and it landed straight on them, and that was quite funny. Yeah. One thing that really stuck out, I pretty much think, is that. I don't remember anything funny, really. Smacked in the face by a baseball bat, and now I suffer from chronic nosebleeds all the time. That wasn't funny. It's funny now, it wasn't funny then. So yeah, that's question whatever the fuck we're on. Okay, question 12. 12. Wait, so what? Are there any special things that you kept from childhood? Yes. I have two entire boxes full of... shit. I assure you. Ow. Ow! You fucking slut. That hurt. Oh my god, you wait a turn. Okay, so these... I feel like I've just been dragged through a hedge backwards. Woo! So these are the boxes that I kept. They're huge. Well, compare them to the size of my head, and I have a pretty big head, let's just say. No, I don't. But yeah, boxes courtesy of Gabby's auntie. They're huge. Jesus Christ. But they're packed with stuff, so... yes, good. And we're not going through it because we'll be here for 600 years. Oh, maybe 605. I don't know. Question 13. The unlucky question for some. Well, maybe. What is a weird thing you used to do as a child? Is that the question? What was something weird you used to do as a child? I was a pretty weird child, but I don't remember something being like significantly weird because weird was just my normal. I don't know. I used to have an addiction to swinging from trees. But you see, again, that's not weird. That's just an actual childhood thing that children do, and then the entire tree falls on them and they have to go to hospital. Yeah, not the best thing. Question 14, what is the scariest thing you remember happened to you when you were younger? Scariest thing? Deep thought. Scariest thing? Don't know again. I don't know. Fuck it. The scariest thing? Being in an earthquake is quite scary. Me and my sister were home alone and there was an earthquake. And we were just like, well, this is great, we're gonna die. We had to run outside and you had to stand in a giant field, middle of nowhere, as the ground was just moving beneath you like a crazy drunken asshole. So yeah, that was quite scary. I mean, it lasted for 2 seconds, but obviously. So that's that. Moving on to question last one. Yeah. How is the world now different from how it was like when you were a child? That isn't correct English. I'll correct you on that one. How is the world different from when you were a child? I'm much more aware of the world. I mean, when I was a kid, I used to live in a bubble. I used to be like, everything's fucking unicorn and rainbows. Unicorn, not unicorn, because there's not just one. You have plural amounts of lots of shit. So yeah, when I was a child, everything was unicorns and rainbows, and now it's more like hell and death and fire. Which I love. So yeah, wow, I sound like a demon child or something. Amazing, you know, you have to pay bills. Pay bills, I don't. And that concludes the throwback tag. That was a dangerous topic. I'm going to address the weekdays quickly. I've only seen Mondays and Tuesdays. So I am sorry Wednesday and Thursday. But I love you and I'll address you next week. It's just I'm in like the worst. That thing right now. So I'm sure you understand. So Monday, yes, your video was crazy. Your video was like, I'm over here, I'm over here, I'm up here, I'm down here. It was having a little dance to itself, which in a way was quite cool. Confused me though, confused me. You were such a cute child. I think everybody looks cute when they're children's. When they're children's. See, English failing already. You know it's time to go when your English starts failing on you. But I think everybody looks like a cute thingy when they're a child. I mean, children are just cute. Cute children. Tuesday couldn't post again because of internet, so at last minute, Aaron had to take over. So thank you very much, Aaron, for being an absolute ninja and getting it on time and being like, whatcha? So yeah, that was good. What else? You talked about the topic that we did last week, which I think we pretty much all just agree on that shit. Like this. Beautiful as ever. Yes. I'm gonna go. I don't want to do too much stuff. I'm gonna show you the canvas before I go and then we're gonna leave. We're gonna go. Goodbye. Not yet, but you know what I mean. It's heavy. Damn you. Don't hit the ceiling. Can you see this? Okay, so that's the base. That's the bottom. It's Mickey Mouse and thingy. And there's the castle. It hurts to hold it up. I'm gonna put it down. Oh my god. Please don't follow me. Would not be cool. I'd have to beat you up. So yeah, that's the canvas that I started working on. Shit, you didn't see the other side. You can see it now quickly. I don't know if you can see that. That's Spider-Man and Batman somewhere. Can you see it? And Spider-Man somewhere there. So yeah, we're done. Goodbye. Sayonara. Bye. Oh no, I didn't say my thing. So until next time, sorry about this video. It's a fail. I love you all, but goodbye, bye, bye. Struck. Let's get this party on. I'm